Hello, D-Light Channel. We are back on our conversation around retirement and how to prepare for it. And last week, I touched on something that I think is the crux and the meat of the series. I introduced to you three umbrellas under which we will be exploring how to prepare for retirement. If you've forgotten or you didn't watch, please let me quickly run through it. The first umbrella is the cognitive preparation. What that means is that everything that has to do with your thought pattern, your thought process, and how you are perceiving your paradigms, your world outlook of what is coming when you hear the word retirement. The second umbrella is the behavioral. Behavioral, which then speaks to how do you manifest the thoughts? How do you interact? What kind of behaviors are you putting forth in your relationship with family, in your relationship with friends, in your relationship in the workplace, in everywhere you are, how are you relating? And the third has to do with your financial preparation. What you will find for the most part is that most of the content available out there think that retirement is all about money, 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 money. How do you save? How do you invest? That's important. But from research and from what we found out, the money part is actually a consequence and not the cause. You find out that where the cognitive preparation is missing, it is usually difficult to come forward with the behavioral preparation. It's usually difficult to come forward with the financial preparation. So I will take the license today to dwell a bit and wallow a bit in the cognitive preparation, even though I started on it last week. Now, when we say cognitive, what does that mean? Cognition speaks to how you are thinking about something, your thought pattern, your thought process, your value system, your belief system, your paradigms. How do you perceive retirement? And it is necessary here to speak to certain specifics. Remember, this is DIY. So we want to speak to the specifics of how to prepare for retirement. The number one is that retirement is inevitable. If you live long enough, at some point, you will have to retire, whether you like it or not. Sometimes it is because your health begins to call for it. Sometimes it is because your organization says you have to leave. Sometimes it is because a combination of factors just make it impossible for you to continue to work. You need to be prepared for that mentally. I said it before, I'm saying it again. If you live long enough, that is going to happen. The second point you need to factor in into your thinking process about retirement is the fact that usually retirement means that you are no longer as powerful as you used to be. Hey, get ready for that. And it's not something that should make you feel less of yourself. One of the problems, the cognitive problem of retirement, has to do with self-esteem. Many people, upon clocking retirement age or having to retire, their self-esteem suffer. All of a sudden, that powerful man that was sitting on a very big fat budget, that had a lot of influence and power, and was mixing and meeting who is who in the community and in the marketplace, now becomes a man that has to book appointment to see certain people. That's life. That's life. Get ready for it. That shock usually make people want to lie, want to hold on to whatever position they were holding, even when it is no longer convenient or advisable. So mentally get ready for it. It's just the normal cycle of life. You will not be the first person to get there, and certainly you will not be the last. And the day you remember this and you start thinking like this, when we get to the behavioral conversation, you will see how this cognitive part shapes everything for you. Number three is that your body will not always be as it has been. Usually, retirement starts tolling the bell that, wait a minute, your body is beginning to wind down. Your denture, some teeth will start falling off. Some eyesight will start getting very shaky, very blurry. Some steps will start getting very shaky and very unsteady. Digestive system begins to act up. And the general body system just begins to tell you a completely different story from what they've been telling. I think it was John Hagee that said that when you are getting old, usually as it approximates retirement, everything hurts, and what does not hurt does not work. Get ready for it. Why I'm talking about it now is because this is the time to prepare for it. Don't ever think that you will always be this strong man, always quick-minded. Memory will begin to fail. Even with the best health condition, you start forgetting things, facts start getting mixed up in your mind. Don't beat yourself up. It means that you are moving to a new level, to a new class of elder statesmen or elder stateswomen, and you are getting ready for what it means to be a senior citizen. Get ready for it. It's not something to lose your self-esteem about. Okay? For some people, at this point, health complications begin to arise. You should actually be grateful that you are alive. You should be grateful that you have lived long enough to deal with some of those health complications. And when we speak about behavioral, I'll begin to mention the things you can do now, particularly if you are still young watching this, to ensure that when you get there, your health condition is as best as it can be. But still speaking about the cognitive part, it is this realization that helps you to be ready for the shock. I remember the first time I took my first step towards retirement. I had a decision to retire very early. I actually set a target to retire before I was 40. I didn't want to work simply because I was looking for the money. I wanted to be able to work just for the pleasure of what I am doing. And it felt completely out of place. I woke up and I walked out, and being so idle, if you like, on a work day was completely shocking. And that made me realize why many people just lose themselves when they run into retirement without preparation. So mentally, you have to prepare for retirement. If you live long enough, it is inevitable. Your status will change. The kind of people that run after you will change. Remember that most of the offices we hold, we are only relevant as long as we are holding those offices. The people that you call one time and they ask you three times, you start calling them for a week, you may be waiting on them. Hey, get used to it. That is part of life, and there's nothing you can do about it. So the cognitive part is very, very important. Start preparing for it now. Think through it. Be aware it's coming. Be ready that things will change. And part of that change has to do with the behavioral preparation. That is what I'm going to be touching on next week. And I'm sure you want to hear what that's all about. So make it a date. Tell your friends, share the video, send us some comments. Don't forget to hit that like button. We'll very much appreciate it. And whatever you do, make it a date next week as we further continue the conversation. T-Mac is still my name. Dila is still the channel. And until I see you next week, don't ever forget that all we are trying to do is what? Make a little difference. Have a wonderful time out there. Bye.